Kua ea te wā ki te taha ko pai waiata. He arotahinga anō tā te whānau nei. He waka tika ware te mahi.
And this is our room. Ooh, it's all white and stuff. We bash this wall down.
Yeah.
So our bed's gonna be there, our baby is gonna be in here. And yeah, this is...
New windows.
This is not the master bedroom, the master bedroom's downstairs, yeah. But because son's up here, we don't want him to be by himself. So we're
gonna move up here
until both the kids are big enough and then we'll leave them. And we'll go into our own space downstairs. So this eventually is gonna be our garage, laundry, and studio building, like a rumpus room slash studio. And yeah, it's just a lot of stuff in here at the moment, but can't wait for it to all come to life and actually be our whare.
Ka koke tonu ngā mahi a te whānau, āpiti atu, he pipi hou kei te waka waha.
Hi.
Yeah.
Kei te pihia te whānau.
There's a lot going on.
Yeah, right. Just thinking about it, I was like, oh, jeez.
Then sometimes we do that, we just sit and we think, we're like, oh, actually, what are we doing? Oh, shit, we're doing heaps at the moment. So, yeah, super pukumahi.
Ai, and kei te tipu te pāhara kiki ni, your whānau's growing. You recently had your new baby.
Kia ora.
Tell me what it was like when you first laid eyes on her.
She came up and we were like, whoa, she looks Māori as. And I don't know if it's because she just came out and like everything's squashed. All squished up. But we're like, whoa.
But we were looking at it and I was thinking, who are you? Go away, Gwen. It's so funny, eh? Because like, I've always been like, I feel how I feel. And I don't like try and feel things the way that she feels things. Like, I'm just like, I am who I am. And like, she'd be like, hun, look at her. Oh my gosh. I was like, I am looking at her. I was like, she's boring. I love her, obviously. Like, yes. But I have my moments by myself. She's starting to get cute now because she's starting to smile and trying to talk and stuff like that. But I was just like, you're beautiful.
Starting to talk.
Oh, you know, wanting to, like, you know, try to do the ooh, ooh, whatever.
Oh, yeah, they're making noises.
But, like, I love it. And it's so funny because we're just this, I feel like we've been a family of four, like, forever. I can't really, I just couldn't imagine our baby not being here, son being a big brother, and just how we operate as a whānau.
Yeah. Carl, put your stall up there.
He wā waka tipu tamariki tēnei mō māmā Lou. He ao hau te awo ngā tamaiti takirua.
It's funny because, like, you know, children, I feel like are just little life suckers.
Yeah.
And they need you. And then they complain, like, son will jump in our bed,
yeah.
And he'll wake up moaning. Like, and I'm like, homeboy, this is our room. This is our bed. He's like moaning, like, oh, I need you to move over, I need this, and I need you to lie down with us. Like, first of all. Like complaining in our bed. And now we've got two of them and I feel like she's gonna be the same. She's a little like, grunter.
Yeah, another time I called him and they were both moaning, like she was grunting and son was moaning about something. I called him up, I was like, can I have some new flatmates?
Kua rua tau tā rātou noho ki Wanganui. He wero nui te noho tāwiti atu I a Tāmaki Makaurau.
I'm really interested in this. You know, with all the opportunities that you both had in Tāmaki Makaurau, opportunities up there for your mahi, Lou, and your accounting work, HR, business, and with you, Stan, of course, you've got your studios and everything. What was the decision to come home?
Well, it all started when he said, hun, I'll go wherever you want to go. If you want to move back to Whanganui, we'll move back to Whanganui. Well, I looked for a job, no.
And I was like, wow. Damn. We're moving to Whanganui, wicked. There is no greater like feeling than having your kids have access to and be brought up in the village, you know, with their cousins and their aunties and uncles and nannies and kuros. Unfortunately, like, I don't have that to give to our kids because my whānau are just, you know, every which way. Mm. We thank God that her family are all in one spot. Whānau nui, tāua tupua. And it's been mean, like our kids, like, you know, son's going to kōhana at Pūtiki, first one to go to kōhana in her whānau, or, you know, they didn't go to kōhana. Like, my dream and our dream is that our kids will go to kōhana and kura kaupapa, that they'll be little haka freaks. Like, I want them to be like, I want my girl walking around and doing a poi all day.
I roto I te reo Māori?
Tahi?
Yeah.
Rewa?
Ai.
Toru?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like a reclamation of our Māori tanga as well, you know, for us. It's been able to give our babies, I mean, you had it more so than what I did, but to be able to be like, hey, you're going to grow up strong in te ao Māori, because we weren't able to. We had to go and learn our reo after uni. We had to, like, come back home and reconnect and ask the right questions and talk to the right people. And it takes a long time to find that confidence.
We're parents that see the value in speaking te reo Māori and going to kohana and kura kaupapa. We see the value in that. We're going to whakamana our kids. We're going to, you know, tautoko them at everything that they do, because it's actually a superpower of ours. It's actually something that sets us apart in the whole world. And we get to do that here. We get to have the freedom to do that here. And we get to, like, have space to for us to be a whānau, and for me specifically to be away from being Stan Walker and where I be Stan Walker. I feel like we've reached a lot of milestones and a lot of our dreams and visions have come alive here in little whānau nui. Like this little thing that's making noise in there, I've got to go and put a dummy in the mouth.
Kia paurana kupu, te hate tuku, te mate aone.
I promise to love you.
He whainga anō I tūtuki e rāua I te tau kua hori. I mārena rāua ki muri wai ki roto o Tāmaki. Ā, I hopukina e Stan ngā pikitia, hei wuti āhua mo te waiata mate mate aone.
We just wanted to get married. We were kind of sitting there like, what are we waiting for? Are we waiting for this big, like, magical moment that we're going to do this? And, like, we got engaged in a garage, having wines. And we just talked about it, and I always joked about it, like, but not joked. Every time I said it, I meant it, but I was like, actually, why do we get met? And it kind of, everything happened the way that kind of we are.
Yeah, very us.
I don't know, and it was, sometimes I think back and I'm like, fuck, I could have did it way more romantic than that, could have did this, but it happened how it did, and I wouldn't change a thing, to be honest.
We just wanted to be married. Like, we're still going to have a big wedding. We're still going to have a bougie big wedding. I want my bridesmaids, and he's going to have his groomsmen, and definitely going to be starting to plan for that. You told me that you love me
bad, but I just don't love you. He hokinga mahara e tihi o ngā waiata hou, pērā I te waiata, the one that you want. Nāna I waihangatia I a rāua e wehe ana.
Some of these songs were birthed out of us not being together. And I remember playing her some of the songs, and I had to play her this one song because, and I didn't mean it in a malicious way, but when we broke up, I was like, I started writing this song.
What were the lyrics, hun?
You told me that you love me bad, but I just don't love you back. I'm not trying to be nobody's man. And so when we come back together, it was like this overwhelming love that we'd always wanted. And like, she was the person and I was the person that she really wanted. Attentive and wanting, you know, I'm still stress-head and still over the top and stuff, but
being able to cook.
Yeah. But clean. Like, so the album process, she gave new life to it. She breathed new life over it of just us, because it was so nice to be able to write happy.
Haunga te tangata e mōhio wānuitia. He mārakirake te kite I tōna wairua maimua ki āna tamariki.
Sorry, my baby, it's cold, eh?
tōna aroha maurua mō tōna hoa wahine, me te wakahi ki tōna ahurea Māori.
We're married, two kids, renovating a home. I think, I know this has like got nothing to do with it, but like in terms of like success and in terms of like cracked it, for me is cracking it. Like, you know, you can have all the money in the world, have the number one record in the world and stuff like that. And like have all the accolades, but that kind of doesn't really matter to me. What matters is that like my original dream is her, these kids, and creating a life and a home for us here. That's my biggest why and my reason why I do anything and why I keep pushing, why I keep showing up, keep turning up, keep doing things. They've become my greatest why.